Okay. In first, what I want to say, I say that every time, my English is not perfect. If you don't understand what I said, ask that to me. It's not a problem for me to repeat one time, two times, three times, or four. Not a problem. Are you okay with that? And like I like in a course is to be more interactive. That means that when I speak, if you want to stop me to ask a question, I prefer a lot. Don't wait the end of the day. I don't understand anything in the first day, in the first minute. Are you okay for that? A lot of questions is better. In SOMA training, the goal for all the technique, GPS, global posture stretching, myofascial stretching, LDOA, strengthening, stretching, proprioception, all need in first. It's not a voyer methodology, you have not a methodology specific. All the methodology, the best argue for me is in relationship with the biomechanics, in relationship with the pathology, in relationship with the anatomy, in relationship with the physiology and the biology and so on. And for that, the most important for the trainer, I think so, when you want to be sure about the exercise, to respect exactly that work to do, to have it's impossible to contest that you do because you have an argue, a scientific argue, not a methodology of somebody. The most important in first is to master the anatomy. For that, after what anatomy? We speak a little about that. For that, each morning, take a little time, 2 hours perhaps this morning, to do a review of the anatomy of the ad. Tomorrow morning, half an hour perhaps, to review the same but differently. And the last day too. That's the most important to master exactly the anatomy. After you have two, three anatomy. You have one descriptive anatomy, classic, that you have in all the book. For me, that is a bullshit. So don't do anything with that. To know where the muscle began, where the muscle finished, and so on. And a lot of names, we don't care. And after you have functional anatomy, why not? But you have two functional anatomy. A functional anatomy like a classic biomechanic. The big problem with the biomechanic, you know the Kaponji, for example? The book, classic book that you have? Kaponji? No? No? Yes, no? Okay, Kaponji is my past teacher. One of the best biomechanic men that we have in the world, he's dying now. But he writes his book 30, 40, more, perhaps 50 years ago. But the big problem with a lot book of biomechanics was the biomechanics from the cadaver. We study the cadaver, we do the dissection of the cadaver, and you elaborate all the movement in biomechanics. And everybody uses that. And that, after in the practice, is totally false. It's impossible to apply. It's very important to know the base for the exam. Do you have an exam? No, you don't need that. You need to apply. And to apply, the most important anatomy, biomechanics and anatomy too, is a tensegrative anatomy. That means the most important is to know the link. And for that, I speak every time, you hear this word 100 times each day, link, 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 link. The link between the muscle and other things. Why? Because in anatomy, classically, the big problem for the trainer, I was a trainer before, like you said, we study the body. Like the body is only bone, joint, and muscle. No visceral, no vein, no nerve, no system, don't exist. And the relationships that you have all the time are between the muscle and the nerve, a nerve and the artery, an artery and a ligament and a bone. And you have one tissue to do the connection between all of that. What is the name of this tissue? Fascia. The fascia. For that, the most important thing are to know the fascia, because with the fascia you have the link. We understand exactly why it's possible to do a global movement with the arm, for example, with the upper limb, and not only if I have the muscle and an disarticulated movement. You understand what I want to say? And each time I will speak about the fascia, and if sometimes you don't know, you don't understand, it's not a problem at all. For me to explain and to try to apply that we want to do. Only if we master that, we can do a lot of, we can master the 200 different exercises that you have for the abs in relationship what you want. Classically, if you want to do somebody yet a hernia, what abs does he need to do? Another one is to lose weight. What abs does he need to do? Another one is a back pain on the lumbar spine. That is rare. No? What abs does he need to do? Another one is because he's an ectomorph. Like me, more short, more large. What abs does he need to do? Another one is an ectomorph, like a Cedric. What abs does he need to do? Okay, another one because he plays judo. Another one plays soccer. What abs does he need to do? Another one is because he wants to go to the Olympic Games in London. What abs does he need to do? Another one, he does the same sport, but for the pleasure. The father, two, three kids, he wants to play. What abs do they need to do? You understand? That is the most important. After, what are the abs? How is possible to work? The poor part, the more proximal part, the more distal part, the more deeper part, superficial part, the middle, an internal range, an external range, in total range. You need to mix all of that. And to mix all of that, one thing, the technology, the methodology, that is not so difficult. After the seminar, you need to, it's not a problem for you to do that. But after to know how to apply that in a relationship with your specific client or specific patient, you need to understand exactly the process. Are you okay? Okay, in first, we see, we can take some notes. If at a time I